Good morning, children.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
You all
good
are
ma'am.
From
good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. You all are from 9th ABC, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, I have unmuted you all. So, when the class, towards the end of the class, last 5 minutes, the ones who have doubts, I'll clarify that. So when I'm teaching, what you need to do is, if you have a doubt, you just raise your hand. You know how to raise your hand in that icon? Raise your hand, I'll keep it there. So that last 5 minutes, I can clarify your doubts. Okay? Yes, Vedant, I will clarify your doubt in the last 5 minutes. Okay. Now, I have already started with chapter one. I've completed that. Just a quick recap. Chapter one was talking about the different evidences which helped us to know that the earth is spherical in shape, like sighting of a ship, then Bedford level experiment, lunar eclipse, then you had the pole star evidence, then you had satellite pictures, then circular horizon, circumnavigation, sunrise and sunset, and earth as a heavenly body. All these, I hope you all can recollect what we had discussed last two classes. Then we discovered that earth is not a perfect spheroid. It is bulging at the equator and flattened at the poles. That means that you all can hear me, na? Yes. So that means that the polar circumference and the equatorial circumference is not the same. When we measure the circumference of the earth around the equator, it is more than what we measure around the poles. So this is because of the rotation of the earth, which caused a force known as centrifugal force, which led to this phenomena. The specific name given to the shape of the earth is oblate spheroid, and the geographical name is geoid. Okay, then we discussed about the different conditions which has made life possible on Earth. First was the Earth is at an optimum distance from the Sun, so it is neither too hot nor too cold. Secondly, we have the atmosphere, which has important vital gases in the correct proportion. And it also has the ozone, which protects the earth from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. Then we have water in all three states available on the earth, in solid, liquid, and gas. Then we had a lithosphere, which consists of soil, which helps in the growth of plants. You all know we cannot take in energy, we cannot convert the energy of the sun directly. So we have the plants which can convert the sun's energy. And when we consume these plants, we can get the energy converted from the sun. You know about the food chain, hydrological chain. So please study that too. Okay. So this will mark the end of chapter one. I have already uploaded one worksheet which has questions and answers, both of this chapter. So please go through that. If there is any doubt, please note and keep it so that that doubt can be clarified when we meet the next time. Arya Gupta, can you sit straight? Yes. Okay. And I request all of you to keep your videos on. I would like to see all of you. That gives a feeling of a classroom. So please keep the videos on. Unless you have some problem, do let me know regarding the net or some video issues, please let me know. Otherwise, keep your videos on. It gives a good feeling that I can see all of you. Yes. Now, then we came to the second chapter. That was on Earth's grid. What is an Earth's grid? It's a network of two sets of lines. Excuse me. Two sets of lines. One set are the lines of latitude and another are the lines of longitude. When they cross each other, they make squares, and this network that they make of crisscrossing lines is known as the Earth's grid. When I say lines of latitude, I mean the lines which are running from east to west on the Earth. When I say lines of longitude, I mean the lines which are running from north to south of the equator. Okay? Then we discuss the characteristics of lines of latitude. Firstly, what is a latitude and what is a line of latitude? Latitude is the angular distance of a place from the equator. And line of latitude is an imaginary line which joins places having the same latitude. Okay, now what are the characteristics of lines of latitude? They are parallel to each other. That is why they are known as parallels of latitude. They also are not of equal length. Their size reduces as we move towards the poles. This is because of the spherical shape of the Earth. So as we move towards the poles, the size of these circles reduces. So which is the biggest circle? Equator. Equator is the reference line as well as the biggest circle or the line of latitude. It divides the Earth into two equal halves, that is Northern Hemisphere and Southern Hemisphere. That is why it is also known as a great circle. Krishna, I cannot see you, dear. Can you place the camera properly? Yes. Because since it divides the Earth into two equal halves, that is the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere, and it passes through the center of the Earth, that is why it is also known as a great circle. Is this much clear? Okay, we move ahead. There are few very important lines of latitude. Tropic of Equator, 0 degree latitude. Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees north latitude. Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degrees south latitude. Then you have the Arctic Circle, that is 66.5 degrees north. Antarctic Circle, 66.5 degrees south. North Pole, 90 degrees north, and South Pole, 90 degrees south. And the equator divides the Earth into two hemispheres, that is the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere. Okay, now we start with the new topic, that is uses of latitudes. Before we start with it, children, in that previous worksheet which I've sent to you, I have mentioned three diagrams. Okay, please lay stress on diagrams in grade 9. It is very important. You can be asked to draw the diagrams. A diagram based question can also be asked. So whatever diagrams are there in your portion according to the council, I will mention it in all the in all the chapters, the worksheets, that these diagrams should be done by you. Okay. Now we come to uses of latitudes. The latitudes that we draw on the Earth, the imaginary lines that we draw on the Earth, has three basic uses. First, it helps us to find the absolute location of a place. If you remember last time we had done, there are two ways of finding a place. One is absolute location and one is relative location. With the help of latitudes and longitudes, with the help of the Earth's grid, the location that we find is known as absolute location. We do not need any other thing to find that location, excepting those coordinates. That is why it's known as absolute location. When we find the location of a place with reference to some other object, for example, what is the location of the chair from the table? So the table is the reference point. From there, we are trying to locate the chair. That is known as relative location. That we write it in direction, northeast, northwest, east, west, south. So that is known as relative location. Absolute location we get from the coordinates, that's the Earth's grid. Secondly, the latitudes also help us to find the distance between two places. We all know that how much distance is there between each degree of longitude. From 0 degree to 1 degree, it is 111 kilometers. From 1 degree to 2 degree, it is 111 kilometers. So suppose a place is at 5 degrees north. How much distance is it from the equator? Can you calculate that? 111 into 5, that is 555 kilometers. So it also helps us to calculate the distance of a place from the equator. Thirdly, very important, it divides the earth into heat zones or climatic zones or thermal zones. Now, what do you mean by heat zones or climatic zones or thermal zones? Places on the earth which have similar type of a climate is termed as a heat zone. The places between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn experience high angle of incidence of sun rays and so has high temperature almost throughout the year. That zone is known as torrid zone. Then you have north temperate zone and south temperate zone, which lies between Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle. And in the southern hemisphere, it lies between Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. This north temperate zone is neither too hot like the torrid zone, neither too cold like the frigid zone. Then you have the north frigid zone and the south frigid zone, which is between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole and the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole. Okay? These frigid zones help us to know the general climate. Sorry, these thermal zones help us to know the general climate of the place. Now, as we talk about the frigid zone, immediately it will strike to you that it will be very cold. If I say place X lies in the temperate zone, immediately you'll be able to understand the place must not be having very hot summers and very cold winters. Europe, parts of North America lie in the temperate zone. So they have good climate throughout the year. Okay, Singapore lies in the torrid zone. So high temperature almost throughout the year. Is this much clear? Tell me, why is it that certain places are getting high temperature and certain are receiving very low temperature? Why is this happening on the earth? Because of the spherical shape of the earth. Because of the spherical shape of the earth, certain places receive high angle of incidence of sun rays and certain places receive slanting rays of the sun. I'm reading from the book. Uses of latitudes. The lines of latitude form one of the coordinates of the grid system. The lines of latitude have the following uses. First, to find the location of a place. Latitudes give us the location of a place north or south of the equator. Such a location is known as an absolute location. Secondly, to measure the distance of a place. Distances are calculated with reference to the equator at right angle to the place. We can therefore measure the distance of any place from the equator based on its degree of latitude. For example, the latitude of Mumbai is 19 degrees north and that of New Delhi is 30 degrees north. We know that 1 degree latitude We know that 1 degree latitude is equal to 111 kilometers. We can say that Mumbai is 2109 kilometers away from equator. Similarly, New Delhi is 3330 kilometers away from equator. So this lines of latitude also help us to calculate the distance of the place from the equator. Now, heat zones, very important. Besides helping us to locate places on maps and charts, lines of latitude divide the earth into distinct heat belts. The lines of latitude indicate the general climate of the area by applying the principle of heat zones or thermal zones of the earth. Thus, latitudes enable us to divide the whole earth into different climatic zones. First one is the torrid or tropical zone. The area lying between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn mark the limits of the torrid zone. It is also called the tropical zone. It is the hottest zone of the earth. Why is it the hottest zone? Because it receives receives high angle of incidence of sun rays because of the spherical shape of the earth. The temperate zone, the other two important lines of latitude based on temperature are the Arctic Circle and the Antarctic Circle. Between the Arctic Circle and Tropic of Cancer, as well as between the Antarctic Circle and Tropic of Capricorn, lie the two temperate zones, the North Temperate and the South Temperate zones. In this region, the climate is moderate, neither too hot nor too cold. The frigid zone, between the Arctic Circle and North Pole and between the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole, are two frigid zones of the Earth. These are the polar regions and receive the sun's slanting rays. Why are sun's slanting rays reaching the frigid zone? Again, because of the spherical shape of the Earth. So in these two zones, very low temperatures are recorded. Children, I hope latitudes and lines of latitude is very clear. Just show thumbs up if it is clear. Okay. Now we move on to longitude and lines of longitude. So what is a longitude? It is similar to latitude. It is the angular distance of a place from the prime meridian. There it was the equator, and here you have the prime meridian. Now, what is a prime meridian? In fact, all lines of longitude run from north to south of the earth, from North Pole to South Pole. They are semicircles which run from North Pole to South Pole. And prime meridian is one of these semicircles. This prime meridian has 0 degree longitude value and it passes through the Greenwich in London. This Greenwich had the Royal Observatory, a place where all these instruments are kept to measure the climate, climatic elements. So in that Royal Observatory, this line of longitude passed from there, and so this was considered as the reference line of longitude. Taking that as the base, they calculated the other longitudes and then they drew the other lines of longitudes. These lines of longitude run from the North Pole till the South Pole. They are semicircles and are of the same length. See, there's a difference between line of latitude and line of longitude. Line of latitude were in varying lengths, but lines of longitude are semicircles of the same length. And prime meridian is the reference line, whereas there it was equator as their reference line. Now the prime meridian is the reference line for the longitudes, and every longitude drawn on the eastern side of the prime meridian has E or East written along with it, and lines drawn on the western side of the prime meridian has W or West written along with it. How many lines of longitude? Now, children, whiteboard option available in share screen, which I cannot get it now. So I will explain, try to explain it. Just look at me because I wanted that whiteboard, which is not available right now. Okay. Now, the lines of longitude, imagine this is the globe. Lines of longitude are the semicircles, which are running from North Pole to the South Pole. How many lines of longitude will you get from the prime meridian on the eastern side? And how many lines of longitude will you get from the prime meridian towards the west? Think of the shape of the earth. From here at 1 degree interval, how many lines of longitude will you get? From the prime meridian till the opposite side of the prime meridian, it becomes a semicircle. At 1 degree interval, how many lines of longitude will you get on this side and how many on that side? 180 from the eastern side and 180 from the western side. And this 180 degrees east and 180 degrees west line coincides, overlaps each other, and it is bang opposite. It is diametrically opposite to the prime meridian. Now, when I say diametrically opposite, what do I mean? You are sitting on one side of the table and a person sitting right opposite to you, facing you, is the other side. This is known as diametrically opposite. So, on the globe, this side you have the prime meridian. Absolutely on the opposite side of that, on the globe, you have the 180 degree east and west longitude. And this east and west longitude are not two separate lines. They overlap each other. Ek ke upar ek hai ye dono. So now the prime meridian and 180 degrees east and west line forms a circle which is going passing through the North Pole and South Pole and also the center of the earth. Yes. So it divides the earth into two equal halves, that is Eastern Hemisphere and Western Hemisphere. So the prime meridian along with the diametrically opposite line, that is 180 degrees east and west, together is termed as a great circle. Understood? Yes. I could see some expressions that gave me a feeling that you all have understood. Now think about 1 degree east. 1 degree east is this side. And the line of longitude, which is absolutely diametrically opposite to that, is 179 degrees west. Together, they form a circle which passes through the North Pole and South Pole, and also passes through the center of the earth. So they also are known as a great circle. Now think about 15 degrees east. There you have a line 15 degrees east. Which line will be on the western hemisphere diametrically opposite that? Any idea? Yes, Arya? Tell me, I can lip read. 165, very good, Arya. 165 degrees west. How did we get that? Because if you see 15 degrees east and 165 degrees west, together they make 180 degree. 1 degree east, 179 degrees west, together will make 180 degree. And these all divide the earth into two equal halves. That is why all lines of longitude along with the line of longitude which is diametrically opposite to that are termed as great circles. Because they divide the earth into two equal halves and they pass from the center of the earth. Is this clear? Now, one very important thing. The lines of latitude are known as parallels of latitude. Is there any other name given to lines of longitude? Yes. They are also known as meridians of longitude. Why? Why meridians? Because each and every line of longitude, again I'm repeating, places on each and every line of longitude will experience 12 noon or midday sun at the same time. Now please look over here. Again, I wanted to draw it, but just try to visualize. Earth is here. This is one line of longitude, semicircle. Sun is this side. So because the Earth is rotating, this line of longitude, all places, be it North Pole, be it some place in frigid zone, temperate zone, torrid zone, southern hemisphere, everywhere places on that same longitude will face the sun once in 24 hours. Once this place will face the sun once in 24 hours, and that time will be 12 noon in all those places. After that, after 4 minutes, the line which was just before that, one line of longitude which was just before that, because the Earth has rotated, now that line of longitude is facing the sun. So those places on that line of longitude, be it in the western northern hemisphere, be it in the southern hemisphere, all these places will receive 12 noon at the same time. That is why lines of longitude are also called meridians of longitude, as they experience the midday sun at the same time. They can be in any of the heat zones. They can be in the northern hemisphere or the southern hemisphere, but all places will experience the midday sun at the same time on that same longitude. Okay, now I will read from the book. Lines of longitude. A longitude is the angular distance of a place east or west of the prime meridian. So this longitude is similar to latitude. Both are angular distance, but latitude is the angular distance north or south from the equator, and a longitude is the angular distance of a place east or west of the prime meridian. The prime meridian is the line of longitude whose angular distance is defined as 0 degrees. It passes through Greenwich near London. The lines to the west of Greenwich are suffixed with W, and those east of Greenwich are suffixed with E. For example, 60 degrees west and 60 degrees east. There are a total of 360 lines at 1 degree interval, because you have 180 degrees on the eastern hemisphere, 180 on the western hemisphere. The lines of longitude are also called meridians of longitude. Very important. This is a very common question, and the board has the possibility of asking this as a give reason. Meridian is derived from the Latin word meridianum, meaning noon. The sun crosses a meridian at noon. All places on a particular meridian will have noon at the same time. All meridians of longitude converge at the poles and are thus of equal length. The prime meridian is numbered as 0 degrees. The others are numbered between 0 to 180 degrees east or west. The line 180 degrees east and west refer to the same meridian. I told you this line overlaps each other. It is diametrically opposite to 0 degree longitude. That is the prime meridian. Thus, 0 degrees and 180 degree meridian together make a full circle round the earth, proceeding at 1 degree interval from both east and west. Other full circles will be 1 degree and 179 degree, 2 degree, 178 degree, 60 degree, 120 degree, and so on. Of the two lines in any segment, one will be in the east and the other in the west. The sum total of two lines will always be 180 degree. Individually, all lines of longitude are semicircles. Next characteristic, the two diametrically opposite lines make a full circle are also known as the great circle. The distance between two lines of longitude is maximum at the equator, that is 111 kilometers. The distance decreases gradually as one moves towards the poles. I need to explain the last point. There was once a question asked, why is it that a giraffe near the equator has to run many kilometers to cross one line of longitude, whereas a penguin only has to hop once near the poles to cross one line of longitude? Does this question make sense? Think about it. Yes. Why? Because of the spherical shape of the Earth, the distance near the equator is quite large. So these lines of longitude are far away from each other near the equator. But since they meet at the poles, they are very close to each other near the poles. So they have to just hop once to cross one line of longitude near the poles. Whereas near the equator, since the longitudes are very away from each other because of the spherical shape of the Earth, so any person will have to run long distance to cross one line of longitude. Is this much very clear, children? Next class, I will be starting with longitude and time. So please keep a rough notebook there with you, because there will be numericals which needs to be done. Today, Vedant, why are you so restless, dear? Hungry? Okay. Next, Krishna, I can still only see your hair, nothing else. Yes. Now, today I will upload one worksheet on this chapter and I will tell you which questions you need to solve. Okay? Please do not sit and solve the whole worksheet because I've not completed this chapter as yet. That time calculation is still to be done. Okay. Now I can see Krishna nodding. Okay. Now, I'll quickly clarify your doubts. Yes. I will unmute you one by one. Arya Gupta. Arya Gupta.
Yeah, ma'am. So ma'am, actually, if you... Like you told us, the Earth is spherical and on 0 degree latitude, if sun rays are coming, all places in the 0 degree latitude will experience 12 noon.
Pardon? All places on 0 degree latitude?
Will experience 12 noon.
No. I am talking about longitude. I am not talking about the latitude.
Sorry,
yes.
Longitude.
Yes.
But then there will be...
I'll tell you. Now, this 0 degree longitude, that is the prime meridian. It passes through Greenwich, is London. It also passes through certain places in Africa. Okay, so it will be 12 noon in those places in London as well as in those places in Africa from where the prime meridian is passing. All what the places, tell me.
What if Earth rotates 1 degree and then the sun rays will come on the other degree, right? So the time will change.
12 noon is over. Now the next longitude, that is suppose that will be 1 degree west, will now face the sun. Correct?
The temperature, the time minutes. Will be same, but temperature will be different.
No, time will be different. Temperature will remain the same. Baba, when we have 12 noon, understand this. When we have 12 noon, after 4 minutes, the longitude which is next to us, we'll have 12 noon because time will keep changing.
No, ma'am, not in the same longitude only, like 0 degree only. The time will be same for all places, but in the North Pole and near the equator, there'll be different temperature.
Yes. temperature will be different, correct, but the time will remain the same.
Okay, and ma'am,
wait, Arya, you are standing at London and one person is standing in Africa, which has the same longitude passing through it. Okay, when you see your time, it is 12 noon at London, and at the same time, the person who's in Africa, where the longitude is passing from, will also have 12 noon.
Okay, ma'am.
The temperature will be different. A person which, who is standing near the equator, that 12 noon is going to be very hot. But a person who is in the temperate zone or near the frigid zone, for them, that 12 noon will not be so hot.
Okay. And ma'am, if
but
you see
the clock will show 12 noon.
Okay.
Yes,
oh, Arya. So, yeah, if you see, there should be 359 longitudes, right? Because 180 and 180 overlaps, right?
What about the 0 degree prime meridian?
Yeah, so
that also needs to be added.
That overlaps on each other.
No, 180 degree east and west overlaps. Okay, but there is 10 degree line prime meridian. That also needs to be added, na?
Oh, so the 360 longitudes and 180 circles.
180, no. Circles, there are 179 because North Pole and South Pole are points.
Oh.
Okay?
And ma'am, can we call each circle as great circle or there's only one great circle?
Which circle are you talking about? From the which is formed by line of latitude or longitude?
Longitude.
Longitude, that one in the eastern hemisphere as well as one which is diametrically opposite to that, it will be termed as a great circle. So but when we talk about line of latitude, only one line of latitude, that is the equator, is the great circle.
Okay, so there are 179 great circles in terms of longitude.
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. Kathy, you had a doubt, dear? Kathy?
Yes.
Yes, tell me.
Since the voice was breaking, I couldn't hear the noon factor. I did not understand that one.
Which part? Kathy, your voice is also breaking.
The whole noon section because my internet connection was not
stable. Okay. All places on the same line of longitude experiences midday sun at the same time. Now also your net is having a problem, Kathy. Now also your net is not clear. When you are speaking, your voice is breaking. Okay? Tanay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, India is not in only one longitude. There are different latitudes for India.
Longitude.
Yeah, ma'am, longitude. Huh. So, huh? But we don't have that much difference in time. So, how will
Why, any idea? But you have put up a very, very good point. Hats off to you. You thought on this line because in one of my sentences, I did mention 4 minute difference. I'm very glad that you noticed that, Tanay. Because in India, we follow a standard time. I'll come to that next class when I'm doing time. There are 3-4 ways in which time is calculated. Local time, standard time, time zone. So I will come to that when I'm doing next class. But I'm very happy that you thought about this. Okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. Yes. Vidhi?
Yes, ma'am.
Vidhi? Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, is the 4 minute thing, does it have a specific reason or?
Yes. It has a specific reason. Although I was planning to do it next class, but still I'll tell you. To complete one rotation, how much time does the earth take? 24 hours?
Yes.
How many lines of longitude are there? 360? Divide it and see. How much time difference is there between every line of longitude? That is 4 minutes.
Okay, ma'am.
Got it?
Yeah,
although
ma'am,
I wanted to do it next class, but still it's good you thought about it. Very good.
Yeah. Yes. And ma'am, the questions which we'll mark and give us, which we have to do.
I will not mark, no dear, I will not mark anything. Only the question numbers I will mention in the WhatsApp that these question numbers have to be done by the children, which you will write in your notebook. Okay?
Yeah, that only.
I will not make your mark it in the textbook.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
Malay.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, yes. One of my doubts were the same as Tanay, so it got cleared. Second one is, ma'am, how many lines of latitudes are there? Is it same as longitudes?
No, dear. It's not the same. There are 360 lines of longitudes and there are only 179 lines of latitude.
Okay. And my other doubt was, ma'am, can you explain that overlapping factor again? I was a bit confused at that time.
See, when you start measuring degrees from 0 degrees, you will have 180.
Yes, ma'am.
In one hemisphere. Again, from 0 degrees, you start measuring 180 degrees. So what will you find? This 180 degrees is from the eastern side also and western side also?
Yeah.
Correct? So these two will overlap each other.
So the 0 degree longitude will overlap the 180 degree longitude?
No, 0 degrees is on the opposite side and 180 degree from the eastern side and 180 degrees from the western side will overlap each other. Zero degree will be bang opposite to 180 degrees east and west line, which is overlapping each other.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Arush. Arush.
Yes, ma'am. I had a doubt in this part, meridian part, when you said that lines of meridian.
Arush, net issue.
Hello, ma'am.
Arush, there is an internet issue from your side. Your voice is breaking. So if you can WhatsApp me your doubt, I'll clarify it or we'll wait for the next time because we cannot get what you're saying. Okay?
Okay.
Yes. Vedant?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me.
Ma'am, I have two doubts, ma'am.
Tell me the
ma'am,
first
one
doubt.
Is that, ma'am, when you spoke about how one giraffe has to run in order to go
yes.
on equator and how one penguin. Ma'am, does it vary from place to place, ma'am?
Yes, it does. If you're absolutely at the equator, on the equator, it will be 111 kilometers. Suppose you are at 10 degrees north latitude, then it will be less than 111 kilometers. Suppose you are at 60 degrees north latitude, it will be very less distance. And when you reach 90 degrees north, you have to just hop and you'll cross the longitude. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
This question was asked in one IAS entrance exam. This giraffe and the penguin question. Okay. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. And my second doubt? My second doubt was that, ma'am, in our worksheets or our book pages, ma'am, they have written we have a local meridian time called which has been denoted by 82 one big apostrophe 30 degree E. How do we pronounce that, ma'am?
I'll tell you. It is 82 degrees. That zero symbol will be there on top.
Yes, ma'am.
82 degrees, 30. Then there will be one stroke on top of that. That is minutes. There is one in between 1 degree line of latitude or line of longitude. You have 60 more lines drawn. Okay. And that is known as minutes. Okay. It's nothing to do with time. It is just that between 1 degree north and 2 degree north, you have many more lines of latitude drawn. Those are known as minutes. And between these minutes also, you have 60 more lines drawn. Those are known as seconds. And that is denoted by two strokes on top. When you go to airport and when you've landed somewhere, you'll see this written. They do not mention the degrees, but they will mention the minutes and the seconds. The place is, suppose I'm telling you, giving an example, 24 degree, 30 minutes, 45 seconds north.
Yes.
Okay, this is how it is mentioned. Got it?
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome, Vedant. I don't think there are any other doubts.
No, so ma'am. There are just two, ma'am.
Who has this doubt? Vedant?
No, ma'am. I had only two doubts, ma'am.
So that means that is the end of all the doubts, na? I've clarified everyone's doubts. Yes? So I'll end the session. There is only one child who had the net problem, so I could not clarify that doubt. Either you call me or we can discuss it next class when there is a... No, there is one who is again showing weight. Arya, I can... Arush and Vidhi. Vidhi, I solved your doubt, dear. Vidhi, I solved your doubt.
Yes, yes.
Arush?
Yes.
Arush, I solved your doubt. Arush?
No, Arush. Ma'am.
Tell me then.
Yeah, ma'am. So the doubt I had is I don't understand the part of the meridians. Meridians what? Or lines of line of meridian. Something you had talked.
What you didn't understand in that, dear?
Ma'am, you said there'll be a question coming. So that question I did not understand. What?
Why are longitudes called meridians of longitudes?
Yeah.
This is because every line, all the places on the same line of longitude experiences midday sun at the same time. That is why they are known as meridians of longitude.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Arya, your doubt is clear?
Ma'am, I had a doubt regarding the project. Can I ask?
Yes, tell me.
Yeah, ma'am, in the project, there are preventive measures for the pollution. So for that also, we have to take one page of each.
Not page, dear. You will write 3-4 points on each. That's all. Points are not pages. Please don't write paragraphs.
Okay.
How to prevent soil pollution. Point 1, point 2, point 3, point 4. Done.
And same goes for the
pollution. 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that.
Same goes for the sources as well.
Correct. Yes. Okay. So this marks the end of our session. If there are further doubts, you please ask me next session. Okay? Okay. Thank you, children. Thank you.